Hi and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika, I'm a graphic designer and I'm writing illustrator books. So let's dive right into this. In this video I'm going to show you how to get a street in perspective. So a street or a road that has these lines at the borders and the dashed line in the center, and it is winded and it needs to be in perspective. So let's dive right in. In order to design the street, we're going to start with a rectangle, and I'm going to delete the stroke, and let's have this just with a fill in a dark gray. Zoom it a little in, and I'm going to make the borders like this. Let's have them in orange, and I'm going to duplicate them with the Alt key pressed. Move it down there, and you see that the smart guides are active in here, so I'm able to align all this perfectly. Let's move it up again with Alt pressed, and you see there is the center, and I'm going to zoom in even closer so we can have these widgets at the sides, and I'm going to press Alt and move them in to get the dashed line in the center of the road like this. So now we have a graphic that can be tiled in order to make an endless road. So in order to do that, I'm going to select all of this and then just move it into the brushes panel and make a pattern brush like so. And you see there's the preview of it and it looks quite well. That's nice. And we won't need the corner tile, so I can also just turn it off. Our road will just be in slopes, and I'm going to scale this down because it's very huge. So let's have it like this and click OK. And now I can draw my road, and I can use the pen tool or the brush tool or the pencil tool. I'm going to take the brush tool and just select this brush. Now let's undo that. Those were still selected, so I'm turning them off. Select the brush and just make the road. There it is. So that is nice, but it's lacking perspective, of course. Now in order to get this to fake some perspective, what you can do is select it, and from up here I can select a width profile like so, and let's mirror this. I'm going to the strokes panel up here and just mirror it so it goes into perspective. That is kind of a perspective, but you see the dashed line in the center is just not in perspective. The dashes should get shorter when going up there. So that doesn't really work. Now I'm going to revert that like so. What we can do is apply an effect. Let's go to Effect, 3D, and Rotate. The Rotate effect makes perspective, but it doesn't create depth. So the object stays flat with it. Now what we do is move that cube so that it has the perspective that we want. Maybe you already have a template image, or you already have created an artwork and you can adjust that. What we also need to do is adjust the perspective slider like so, which is very extreme. So you see Illustrator cannot render that. We need to move this back. Now when you go farther than 100 degrees, Illustrator most of the time can't really render that. So we have to stay at low values down there. So that's okay, and there we have a road in perspective. If that isn't enough, so if you think, well, it should get even narrower down there, you can still go and select this path and then apply the width profile like so in addition, and you can also again mirror that, and you know, you get a stronger perspective with this. You can also adjust that, and you take the width tool, go in here, and the profile is like so, and maybe you want to adjust like this, so it looks more realistic, like so. So this is one method to do that. Now let's take a look at another one. I'm taking the pencil tool for this one, like so. There's the next road, and you see all the effects are already applied, because in the appearance panel, which is this one, there was an option checked, this option, new artwork has basic appearance. You know, I need to check that, and then when I create a new object, it doesn't get all the effects, but now I'm just going to delete them, and I'm also going to delete this one. So I've got the view from above. Down here we have a mistake in the drawing. I'm going to delete that one point, so it's clean now. And in order to show you the next method, what we need to do is flatten the appearance. This is still a brush, and the brush won't work with the other method. So what I need to do is go to Object, Expand Appearance. So there we have paths now. You see in outline view it looks like this, and the other path looks just like this. Everything else is just effects. And what I can now do is set up a perspective. So I'm going to the perspective tool, and there is the perspective grid, and let's just move it over here. And I can now take the perspective selection tool and take this object and move it in there. But first I'm going to select the bottom plane and just move it in here, and there we have the perspective. So I could also adjust the perspective grid, of course. Let's do that. And for this work I need to first go to perspective grid and lock the station point. And now when I adjust that, you see the object moves with it, like so. So those are the methods you can use to get your road in perspective. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.